Hello and welcome. It's been a particularly harrowing time for retail investors, having put in their life savings, shelling out steep EMIs every month for their dream home, now left in the lurch with the courts setting aside land acquired for several of those housing projects. The focus this evening, of course, on the two such cases in Noida, Uttar Pradesh. And joining us this evening to answer some of those queries you may have, in an IBN sir, Mr. Harsh Roongta, CEO of apnaloan.com, is joining us there from Mumbai. You need to know before you put your money, your life savings in that property, some of the pointers that you need to look at here. Buy a ready-to-move-in property, avoid the risk of buying a promise, in a sense. If you do have to buy under construction property, make sure that the property is pre-approved by at least one of the big lenders like Axis Bank, HDFC, ICICI or SBI. While the liability remains yours despite the pre-approval, it is still better than the other properties that do not have such a pre-approval. Never ever choose an advance disbursement facility. Right, I believe we are also joined by Mr. R.K. Arora, Mr. Goswami from Guwahati, who is on the phone line. What's your question, sir? Go right ahead.
Like, I'm a purchaser of Amrapali Golf Home. So, is it safe? Golf Home, okay. Amrapali.
Right, and
I purchased a flat in Golf Home, Amrapali. Is it safe in Noida Extension?
In Noida Extension. Mr. Harsh Roongta, can I bring you in here? You're sitting there in Mumbai, but specific question about the Amrapali Golf Home here in Noida Extension. I understand still not under a cloud given the two court orders that we have in hand, but we know there are a couple of other land acquisitions that are being looked into by the Allahabad High Court as well. What would you tell a retail investor like Mr. Goswami, who's calling in from Guwahati? How can he be certain whether or not his property is safe?
I think the key thing to check is in the document that he would have signed, there would be a narration of how the builder has acquired the title, and if it has been acquired under the same route where the state government has used the emergency clause. Unfortunately, this has almost become like a TV serial. You're going to see a string of judgments that are expected over the next 2 to 4 weeks and maybe even later. There are a whole lot of cases that are currently going on. And I think he would be best advised to assume that it is in problems until it is proven otherwise, because I think a lot of land was acquired from the state government for Noida Extension. Right answer to this only the builder can provide. I would not be able to provide it builder wise. I think that information would only be available with the builder.
Fair enough. In fact, Mr. Goswami, if you're listening in there, we spoke to the Amrapali chairman, Anil Kumar Sharma, just a short while back. Here are some of the promises that he's holding out. We don't have a specific answer to the property that you're referring to, but in case it is, I'd like to bring in the builder's point of view as well. Before that, a word from Ashish, one of our viewers, also calling in from Noida. Ashish, what is it that you want to say this evening? Do you have a specific question?
My question is banks like LIC, HFL, PNB, HDFC are giving loan for the property? Is the project safe or is out of any legal terms?
Mr. Roongta, could you take that question? Can a retail investor safely assume if these are the banks that he is referring to that have given loans for the property, would it be safe to say that this will be a safe property to invest in?
First of all, what is the legal position? I think the legal position is clear. If a consumer looks at the agreement that he has signed, all that the pre-approval indicates is the fact that the bank is willing to lend against this property. The risk arising from, say, the delay in delivery or there being issues with the title, etc., continue to remain with the customer. That clearly is the legal position. Irrespective of whether the property has been pre-approved by somebody or not. The points that we mentioned right in the beginning, that other things remaining the same, a pre-approved property is probably better than a property that's not pre-approved. But the risk remains with the consumer, unfortunately. In fact, if he refuses to pay the pre-EMI interest, right, his credit score and his own credit record with the credit institutions will get spoiled. We have cases like that
All right, Mr. Roongta, I think that's fair enough. Another of our core, Big Noida housing mess. We're looking at the options available to you, the retail investor whose dream house has come under the cloud post those court rulings quashing land acquired to build those housing projects. I believe we have one of our viewers who's calling in this evening. Nasir from Noida. Jyoti, I beg your pardon, here from Delhi. Jyoti, what is your question?
I want to know, why did banks in first place approve loans for this area? And now that they have done that, which means they had also not done their research properly. And in case now they have done it, what happens to the EMIs? Do I keep paying them?
Mr. Roongta, could you take that specific question about the EMIs before I come to Mr. Giri about the culpability of the banks that have provided loans for properties like this? Does Jyoti continue to pay the EMIs for a property that has now come under a cloud that has been backed by or underwritten by banks such as those that we've been mentioning?
Well, I think in this particular case, at least prima facie, and I think legal personalities like Mr. Giri would be better able to answer that, but clearly it seems that the builders are as much a victim as the, and therefore the banks and the final customers. Clearly, I think the issue is at the acquisition stage, at which stage none of the other parties were involved. I think at least as far as this particular project is, this particular kind of acquisition is concerned, I don't think it would have been possible to find out this issue beforehand, before the cases were filed. There is a possibility that over the last 1 year after it was known, during the last few years when it was known that the cases have been filed, possibly banks would have been cautious, and I think different banks have stopped lending in this area at different points of time. But as I said in the answer to a previous question,
right,
on paper the clear liability is of the customer. If he or she does not pay the pre-EMI interest or the EMI to the bank, she runs the risk of spoiling the credit information record that is maintained with the credit bureaus.
Right.
Therefore, right now, while you might take legal action against all parties concerned, I think it would be a good idea to continue paying the installment amounts,
right,
if you don't want to spoil your credit record.
A bit of a catch-22 for the retail investor here, some would say, Mr. Roongta.